Chihuahuas are fantastically popular dogs that are available in several different flavors, including 9 different colors, 6 different patterns, and both long and short-haired varieties. But there is one more way in which Chihuahuas vary, the shape of their heads. Today, we'll tell you the major differences between the Applehead Chihuahua and the Deerhead Chihuahua. Number 9. Appearance. As the name implies, the most obvious difference between these two gorgeous Chihuahua varieties is the shape of their skull. We'll start with Applehead Chihuahuas first because they conform to the ideal standard. These dogs have a round, apple-shaped head that looks much like a dome. This broad head is paired with a short muzzle, the two meeting at roughly a 90-degree angle. This apple-shaped skull tends to make the dog's eyes much more prominent, which is a very endearing characteristic, while Applehead Chihuahuas tend to be slightly smaller in size than their deer-head counterparts. They have shorter legs and necks, which makes them one very adorable little package. Interestingly, Applehead varieties are usually born with molares. Just like a fontanelle on a baby, a molera is a soft spot on the skull where it hasn't entirely fused together. This spot may never fully close, so you'll need to be cautious when handling your pet, just as you would need to be with the head of any dog. Meanwhile, the Deerhead Chihuahua is recognizable by their longer, narrow head that is somewhat reminiscent of, you guessed it, a deer. This dog's longer snout meets the forehead with a slope rather than a right angle, so those gorgeous eyes are often less pronounced than on Applehead Chihuahuas. Number 8. Applehead versus Deerhead Chihuahua skull shape. Chihuahuas display one of two different skull shapes, apple-like or deer-like. At the risk of being painfully obvious, Applehead Chihuahuas have heads shaped like apples, while Deerhead Chihuahuas have heads shaped like, wait for it, the heads of deer. It's usually pretty easy to distinguish the two, but if you're having trouble, look at the place where your Chihuahua's muzzle meets his face from the side. Applehead versions will have a roughly 90-degree angle at this point, while the same part of a Deerhead Chihuahua will be about 45 degrees. Simply put, the Applehead Chihuahuas features a face that is essentially vertical. The faces of the Deerhead Chihuahuas are sloped. Additionally, the forehead of apple-shaped Chihuahuas is much more prominent than those of deer-headed individuals. The large eyes and small rounded head makes the apple-headed Chihuahua appear physically reminiscent of a human baby, which is one reason why we humans find these Chihuahuas so darn cute. There are a number of other differences between the two varieties, but these are the most noteworthy. We'll discuss the other differences a little later on. Number 7. Temperament. These dogs have slightly different temperaments even though they are the same breed. Despite there being no scientific proof the head shape of the Chihuahua affects their temperament in any way, mainly Chihuahua parents say deer heads are more sociable and more obedient compared to the Applehead. However, it is likely their environment and upbringing form their temperament, and the shape of their heads has no bearing. Both the Applehead and the Deerhead are equally as confident, intelligent, and stubborn. They both employ a no-nonsense approach and do not suffer fools easily. Despite this, they are very cheery pups who have a love for life. They love to play and are very friendly and affectionate towards their family. They are both described as having cheeky, terrier-like temperament qualities. They crave companionship, which makes them very sociable, but also means they may suffer from separation anxiety. Chihuahuas are known to bark a lot when not properly trained or socialized. This can result in the overprotectiveness of their family. They may snap if their behavior is not corrected. They are both wary of strangers, and if they don't like something or someone, you will know about it. So, if it's a small protective dog that you are after, these guys are known to be quite good guard dogs. Despite being part of the canine toy group, they both have a medium prey drive, which means when they see something small and furry, they chase it. Number 6. Exercise. Both the Apple and the Deerhead are considered to be medium exercise dogs who need about 30 minutes a day. The Chihuahua does not require particularly intense exercise. Walking will suffice. If you plan to harness train your Chihuahua, make sure you look at Chihuahua size harnesses to make that transition easier for this headstrong breed. If you have an enclosed yard, they will happily have a good romp around chasing birds and squirrels. Be mindful that the Applehead is likely to suffer more with his breathing, so on hot days, his exercise should be monitored. If necessary, only take them out early in the morning and later at night when it's cooler. Number 5. Training. Obedience training from early on is essential for these pups. These guys are quite intelligent pups, and they are known to quickly pick up commands. However, they are fiercely independent, and as such, if they decide that today is not the day to partake in training, then you are unlikely to be successful. Because of this stubbornness, early obedience training is key. It is also important to socialize them very early so that they are comfortable with other humans and larger dogs. This will help with their yappy barks and aloofness with strangers. Number 4. Apple-headed Chihuahuas are the breed standard. Technically, to conform to the AKC breed standard, Chihuahuas must have apple-shaped heads. So, if you are interested in showing your dog, it is important to look for an apple-head variety. However, there is certainly nothing wrong with deer-head Chihuahuas, and a few have even become famous. Additionally, as long as both of your Chihuahua's parents are AKC registered, you can register your Chihuahua, no matter what shape his head is. There is always the possibility that the AKC and other registration clubs will start recognizing two separate varieties, but only time will tell. This is a contentious subject among those who work with the breed. Number 3. Which came first, the apple or the deer? Nobody knows exactly why or how Chihuahuas began producing differently shaped heads. In general, the breed's history is somewhat complex and unclear. Some sources report that remains of Chihuahuas that lived thousands of years ago, representing both varieties, have been collected. This complicates the situation and makes it likely we'll never know exactly which skull shape came first. Interestingly, Applehead Chihuahuas occasionally appear in litters produced by two deer heads, and vice versa. However, this doesn't appear to occur in any sort of predictable pattern. You never know when you'll get a surprise. Number 2. What else is different about Deerhead and Applehead Chihuahuas? Aside from head shape, the two different kinds of Chihuahua exhibit several other differences. Some of the most noteworthy differences include: most Applehead varieties have a soft spot on their skull at birth, termed a molera. This is less common with Deerhead varieties. Deerhead Chihuahuas usually have longer heads, necks, and legs than their Applehead counterparts do. Deerhead versions are generally longer and leaner than Applehead Chihuahuas. The eyes of Applehead Chihuahuas typically appear more pronounced, given the shape of their heads. Conversely, the ears of deer-headed Chihuahuas appear more prominent and are set higher on the head than those of apple-headed Chihuahuas. While still basically similar in size, deer-head Chihuahuas are often slightly larger than the other variety. Number 1. Health problems. Okay, so deer-head Chihuahuas and apple-head Chihuahuas look different. But does that have any effect on their overall health of these dogs? Unfortunately, the answer is yes. Applehead Chihuahuas are susceptible to a wider range of health problems than deerheads. The abrupt angle at which the snout meets the head means these dogs are more likely to suffer from respiratory problems like reverse sneezing and tracheal collapse, while dental and eye issues can occur as well. The shortened head also places these Chihuahuas as an increased risk for hydrocephalus, or water on the brain. However, the Chihuahua Club of America points out that hydrocephalus is not linked to the presence of Mollaris. Do let us know in the comments which one of them you like the most. Please subscribe to the Amazing Dogs. Thanks for watching.